Fine. All right. Kalpana, let me ask you, you know, on the back of what we've just heard from Mr. Kotak as well as Mr. Rajneesh Kumar, how much of a challenge is this going to be as we push ahead with the battle for growth? I mean, this was, you know, our tryst with getting back to the sort of 7.5%, 8% kind of growth number. Do you believe that this is going to be a speed breaker? It's going to be a hump? How is it likely to impact the tryst for growth?
So certainly the growth in the NBFC sector has to shrink, right? I completely agree with what Uday and Mr. Rajneesh Kumar said earlier. This is a liquidity issue and not an asset quality issue. But given that they are going to be shrinking, the slack has to be taken up by the banking sector. Now the private banks are already operating at close to 98% credit to deposit ratios. So their maneuverability in terms of a significant growth, unless the deposit growth picks up significantly, is going to get challenged. That's why I'm such a votary of securitization that both of them referred to. And I think today securitization is possible through horizontal strips.
Okay.
So I'm not as pessimistic about the mutual funds.
Okay.
If we give them the right tools to manage for up to 1 year maturity through these securitization strips, I think we can just break this blockchain.
What would be the biggest red flag that you want to highlight today outside of this?
I think if there is a complete freeze mode on the part of the banks, that is a red light for me, which fortunately state banks already announced a 45. If more of the other banks that are not constrained by PCA and some of the private banks, if they can think of a way of securitizing their own portfolio and then cherry picking the NBFCs, I think we can quickly break.
Okay, let me move.